Hello, everybody. My name is Mr. Patrick, and I'd like to say thank you for joining me today. Oh, yeah, just in case you want to see for sure. My name is Mr. Patrick, and I am here to sing a couple of songs for you. And not only am I here, but I brought a friend of mine along with me, thanks to the technology, the magic technology. We have Miss Kerry, the world. Years of preschool. What a wonderful place that is. Hello, Miss Kerry. How are you?
Good, Mr. Patrick. How are you?
I'm doing great. Enjoying the beautiful weather today. I hope that everybody out there is safe and doing okay and has power and is doing all right. Got through it or okay. I thought, we're here. And I have a guitar, and you have an extensive knowledge of American Sign Language. So perhaps it would be a good idea to do a couple of songs together and maybe talk about the songs and have you interpret them. What do you think? Do you think that people at home might like that?
I think that sounds great. I know I would enjoy it. So.
Yeah. So we've got two amazing songs for you today. I know that Miss Kerry, you've talked a little bit about how you got involved and learned American Sign Language, but just in case there's anybody out there who has not heard that, if you can give just a quick rundown of how you first got interested in it and how you learned it.
Of course. So I first started getting interested in it when I was in high school. I had a deaf student that sat in front of me in a history class of mine, and we became friends, and I learned a little bit about the language, and he spoke mostly sign language, but he was also lip readers. But I was just really in awe of the language, and I really enjoyed our friendship. So when I graduated high school, I decided to pursue sign language, and I ended up falling in love with it. And I learned the language, I learned how to interpret, and I learned how to teach it, and here I am.
There you go. That's wonderful. So yeah. You never know where something is going to lead you. I don't think any of my friends had anything of interest to me, so here I am with my guitar instead. So we are going to do two songs today, not just one, everybody. We have two songs planned, and I will tell you, look at that, she's interpreting right there. I don't even know, she may have said something about me. Now
yeah, I'm getting two songs.
She just, well, I don't want to do the Italian signs that my grandmother I don't, those are not American sign language. But our first song, I'd like to talk about. Hello, Emerson and Quinn. Glad you're here. Are you guys poolside? I have a feeling they are. That is great. I think they are watching from the pool. Who's got a better life than Emerson and Quinn, guys?
That's pretty great. Nice. Thanks for tuning in.
That is great. I'm kind of jealous, actually. We'll have to do a special show from poolside. What do you think, Miss Kerry, at some point?
That sounds great.
So our first song is by a band that some of you may have heard of, a band from lovely Liverpool, England. And no, I'm not talking about Jerry and the Pacemakers, although they were also from Liverpool, England. Nobody really wants to hear any of this song. Sorry, Jerry. But we're talking about not the Quarrymen, they're an original name, or the Silver Beatles. We're talking about the Beatles. And the song that we are going to do today is called All You Need Is Love, right? Look at that. She's doing it right there. All You Need Is Love, everybody. One of the most wonderful songs that's ever been written. That was written by a fellow named John Lennon. In 1967, he was writing this song, and it was chosen when the Beatles did the very first live satellite broadcast in June of 1967. It was the first one where people from all over the world were watching. Each country got to present its own artists, own people doing things. And fortunately for Great Britain, they happened to have the Beatles lying around. Who can beat that? So John saw it, right? I mean, come on. If it was the 70s, the United States would have said, well, we have the Bay City Rollers. No, they're from Scotland. Sorry, my bad. So John wrote it as he called it almost like a propaganda song, trying to get the word out about love. He'd already written the song The Word from Rubber Soul to try to with the same kind of idea. It was recorded live in front of, I read, 400 million people, not bad, all around the world. They, part of it was already recorded. The Beatles then recorded their tracks in the studio with plenty of guests who were singing along, clapping, and also playing various instruments. And it's a wonderful song. Hopefully a lot of you already know it. It's very simple and direct and really, really reaches the heart. So Miss Kerry, if you could just tell us a little bit about the American Sign Language interpretation for All You Need Is Love, that would be great.
Yeah, this is a great one, guys, because there are a lot of repetitive lyrics. The chorus just repeats and repeats. So if you want to sign along and you don't get it the first couple of times, you could just keep signing along and get it towards the end. So the chorus is All You Need Is Love. And when we discussed sign language and the parameters and things like that, you'll remember that sign language sometimes is a little backwards from spoken English. So the way the chorus is going to go is we're going to start with all. So all, you just kind of give a flip of the wrist. Remember the five parameters of sign language, the hand movement, the body, where it is on the body, and the handshake. So you're just going to do a flip of the wrist, and you're just going to slap it on your hand. You just do a little flip. That's all. That's like all. Yeah.
There we go.
All.
Okay.
So they have no is. So what you're going to do next is need. Need, you're going to take the X handshake, which looks like a hook. And you're going to just do that. That's it. That's the need. 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 Right? Need.
Okay.
And then since they don't have conjunction words, so it's all you need. And then they say, what? What? So just, what? Palm up. Just kind of shrug your shoulders and be like, what? And then the last sign is love. And you just take the X with your wrist at your heart and you push it out.
Oh, Daniel and I say hello, Mr. Patrick and Mommy.
Oh, hi, my love. Oh, my firstborn. He's the best.
Oh.
So love. You take the X with your wrists at the heart and you push it out. That means love.
Like a heartbeat.
Exactly. So remember we talked about emotions are usually at the chest because that's where your heart is. So you love with your heart.
Mm-hmm.
Love. So all you need. What?
Love. Oh, so we're asking a question. What do you need? And then...
Exactly. Because there's no conjunction. There's no is, if, at,
right.
Anything like that. So there you go. So that is going to keep repeating. So if you want to sign along, you're going to see all, need, what?
Love. I did that a lot in high school when they called on me. I don't know.
Same.
Yeah. There you go. So... Wonderful. All right. So we might as well start. I will start on the guitar. And guys, try to, if you can, sign along with Miss Kerry. You can also sing along with Mr. Patrick. As long as you have fun, that is the main thing here. So I hope everybody enjoys it. And Emerson and Quinn, if you guys are swimming, it might be a little hard to do American Sign Language, but you never know. You can give it the old college try. So... Here we go. We're not going to bring it in with the Marseille, the French national anthem.
I want to yes. I was wondering about that.
Right. Nice little sway. First verse. Nothing you can do that can't be done. There's nothing you can sing that can't be sung. Nothing you can say, but you can learn how to play the game. It's easy. Another verse. Nothing you can make that can't be made. No one you can save that can't be saved. Nothing you can do, but you can learn how to be you in time. It's easy. Here we go. All you need is love. All you need is love. All you need is love. Love. Love is all you need. Instrumental break. She's playing air guitar. to the chorus. Here we go. All you need is love. All you need is love. All you need is love. Love. Love is all you. Last verse. Nothing you know that isn't known. Nothing you can see that isn't shown. There's no way you can be that isn't the way you're meant to be. It's easy. All you need is love. All you need is love. Come on, everybody. All you need is love. Love. Love is all you need. One more time. Come on. All you need is love. All together now. All you need is love. Everybody. All you need is love. Love. Love is all you need.
Awesome.
Awesome. And Miss
Kerry cool.
Did this during the big ending there. So
that's how the death clap.
Really? Is
yes.
it?
Yep.
Wow. That is really interesting.
Very visual.
It occurred to me, and I forgot about this, that regarding that song, about, I don't know, 2 or 3 years ago, I played every year on the summer solstice. There's something called Make Music New York, where people play music all over the city on the solstice. I think it's the 21st of June. And I played in Brooklyn with my band, the Rockasilly Band. We were playing that song in Park Slope. And a fellow walked over, and he wasn't deaf, he was blind, but he had a harmonica, and he said, do you mind if I sit in with you? And he played a harmonica while we played that song, just sitting there on 7th Avenue or 6th Avenue, wherever it was.
That's amazing.
It just brings people together, and that's wonderful. So
I didn't know that about the solstice. Like, I would love to get in on that somehow.
Yeah.
And I love Park Slope. We almost moved there.
There you go. I would love to, but, you know. So. You guys love that song. I'm so glad. Look at that.
I love you, buddy.
Oh, good.
I'm glad.
So, we're very careful. Miss Kerry and I are very careful in our song selection. We want to make sure that we keep everybody happy. We don't want to have any clunker songs. We go for very high quality. They are all vetted. They were all passed through extreme, you know, standards. So we make sure they're good. And speaking of which, our second song is just that kind of song. I don't know if you can hear in the back, my dog is barking. He loved that song too, and he loves the next one. And this one is a particularly meaningful song in the day and age of the quarantine with COVID, because it has a rainbows theme. The rainbows. Shout out to my friends from Rainbows Reach. So the Rainbow Connection is the song that we are going to do next. The Rainbow Connection from the Muppet movie. When I say
that's
that,
one of my favorites.
It's one of my favorite movies of all time.
Me too.
Very
Me too. Love the Muppets. Love that song. Love the Muppet movie. Love it all.
The guest stars are just out of control, because it has Mel Brooks, Steve Martin, Richard Pryor,
Madeline Kahn.
You can't.
Steve Martin.
Absolutely.
Crazy.
Yeah.
I think Bernadette Peters.
If you happen to ever be playing the Kevin Bacon game, you want to use the Muppet movie as much as possible, because it has people like Bob Hope and these old time guys. And Steve Martin was in it. And Steve Martin was in Planes, Trains, and Automobiles with Kevin Bacon. Just putting it out there, guys. You don't want to go Kevin Bacon versus me, because I use the Muppet movie. Anyway.
It's a fun game, too. It's a really fun game. If you know your movies.
There you go. So I remember seeing that in the movies when I was a child with my parents. That's how old Mr. Patrick is. So I'm sorry for going off on a tangent. I tend to do that sometimes. I lose track. But the Rainbow Connection was written for that movie by a fellow named Paul Williams. You may know Paul Williams. He was that guy I don't know if you guys remember the 70s, the glasses, the long hair, kind of funny looking. He was in the Muppet movie. He played the piano player who introduces Foxy the Bear. It was also written, I didn't know this, by a guy named Kenneth Asher. And they wrote it for the movie. It was nominated for an Oscar, and it somehow didn't win. It lost to a song from the movie Norma Rae. Now, not only does that, the fact that we don't even know what movie that is tells you about the unbelievable, unjust nature of the Oscars. They didn't give the Oscar to Rainbow Connection. However, the song has gone on to become somewhat of a standard recorded by people like the one and only Willie Nelson. I'm sure that Miss Kerry knows that, right? Sarah McLachlan, and she's like, yeah, I know.
I love her too. No, I kind of love her too. She's good. She's great.
She's good. I may have done ever. I don't know. I just, it's one of those songs that, oh, Judy Collins recorded it as well. So
I think the Dixie Chicks too did it.
Ah, so you, it's, I think, you really can't go wrong with it. Just puts you in a happy mood. Sung by Kermit the Frog, voiced by Mr. Jim Henson, one of my heroes in the movie. So I'm very happy to do this song. Miss Kerry, if you could just give us some lowdown on the Rainbow Connection and how to do some of the signing for it.
Sure. So again, a couple of signs you're going to see is rainbow and connection. And rainbow is one of my favorites because it kind of looks like a rainbow. And if you remember the parameters of how the signs move, you're going to put your hands together at the beginning of the arch of the rainbow facing your body. And then you're just going to scoop one arm over, arch over your head, like a beautiful rainbow just hovering over your head.
Mm-hmm.
That's
okay.
Rainbow.
Okay.
And connection, you're going to take your two fingers, you're going to link them like a chain. Together, connected.
Ah, rainbow connection.
So think of a chain link connecting, right. And that's how you remember connection.
Can you use that for Fleetwood Mac, the chain too? Just wondering.
Sure, yes, of course. Never Jesse, break the chain, right?
Be a little weird, but we could do that song someday. I don't know. So.
Sure.
So
I'm a big music fan, so yes.
There you go. I know. We can do it all 80s. We could really like get a little out of control. Before we do, I just need to hydrate since we're going to be singing a few lyrics. And
I was just reiterating. Yeah. Rainbow connection.
And do you have to do that when you do the connection or you just hold it?
Well, so the rainbow that's connecting, like what we're connecting to is the rainbow. So you're gesturing towards the sky, which is where the rainbow would be.
Okay.
So it depends on, like, if we're connecting as a musical group, we would be like this.
Okay.
You know?
Uh-huh.
It depends on, you know, the situation.
Okay. So it's different depending on the situation. All right. So the Rainbow Connection from the Muppet Movie, guys, please remember how to do I don't do it as well as Miss Kerry. Rainbow and then the connection to the sky. It's hard to do when you're holding a guitar. I'm just saying. Let's do it. You ready, guys? Please sign along, sing along. You can do both. Just have fun. And we hope that you guys at home enjoy this. So.
Okay.
Why are there so many songs about rainbows? What's on the other side? Rainbows are visions. Illusions, rainbows have nothing to hide. I'm forgetting the words. Da, 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 da. Sign him as Kerry. What?
I know they're wrong. Wait and see.
Someday we'll find it. The rainbow connection. Lovers, dreamers, and me. Thank you, Barbara. Nice M&M. Got it. Who said that every wish be heard and answered? Wished on the morning star. Somebody thought of it. Believed it, what it's done so far. I got it. What's so amazing that keeps us stargazing What do we think we might see? Someday we'll find it. Rainbow connection. Lovers, dreamers, and question. Have you been half asleep? And have you heard voices? I've heard them calling my name. Is this the sweet sound that calls the young sailors? The voice might be one and the same. I've heard it too many times to ignore it. It's something that I'm supposed to be. Someday we'll find it. Rainbow connection. Lovers, the dreamers, and along. I've only sung that song about 10,000 times. My brain decided to forget the words today, but 2 out of 3 ain't bad. Thank you, Dan. I think
pretty great.
Nice emojis, guys. You got Barbara. You are no joke with the emojis. There's a frog, and wow, that's
pretty good.
So we're just about done, but before we go, I just wanted to say thank you, Miss Kerry, for doing
this. Thank you, Mr. Patrick.
It is always fun and a pleasure to do this with you. I would like to also thank the good people at Gotham Trinity Productions for helping us to put this show on. Let's hear it for Gotham Trinity Productions. You guys rule.
Yes, it wouldn't be possible without you guys. So thank you.
So thank you. Is that it? Is that right? Thank you.
Thank you. Yep.
Thank you.
At the chin. Palm in. 5 palm in at the chin. Extend out. Thank you.
Thank you. Gotham. I won't ask how to do Gotham Trinity Productions because
I have to figure all that.
So thank you to the chain would be great too. Yes, it would. We got to think about that. So thank you, everyone. And thank you for tuning in, everybody. We are so glad that you tuned in. We are so happy to do these for you. And we will put our heads together and come up with another date and some more songs. And I'm sure we'll be doing some more. But until that time, have a wonderful day and enjoy the beautiful day. Stay safe. My name is Mr. Patrick, Music with Patrick, and I hope to see you guys again real soon. While I have you, can I just tell you, I have a live show on Friday at 4:00 at Empire Outlets. It's socially distanced. It's going to be a lot of fun. I miss live music. So if you want to come down and see me in person, whether I don't know if that's a good idea or not, you know, look at me. Come on.
I think it's a good idea. It's going to be a beautiful day right by the water. The view is great down there. The shopping.
There you go.
Why not?
And Old Navy. So.
Yes.
So thank you, everybody. Have a wonderful day. Thank you. And is this goodbye?
Yeah, bye. Sure. Wait. Yeah. I mean, and kind of salutation of anything.
Okay. Yeah. That's great. Yeah. So thank you, everyone. We'll see you soon.
Bye, guys. Thank you.
Oh, my. What's going on with hair? I don't know.